I think Mintz Levin is unique in that so many people come to Mintz Levin because of its rich tradition in pro bono and community service. So I came to the firm 17 years ago with the hope of really focusing on doing a significant amount of pro bono work, and I'm not alone.
Mintz Levin has always valued pro bono work, even from its inception 77 years ago. The founders of Mintz Levin were very active in the community, and that's continued to this day.
The firm's most proud of our work in domestic violence and sexual assault. We've really been able to make an impact not only with individuals who are victims of domestic violence, as well as representing nonprofits that don't have the resources to hire counsel.
The Boston Area Rape Crisis Center really relies on Mintz Levin to help with pro bono representation. But in addition, whenever anything comes up on a more systemic level, on a policy level, Mintz Levin is always the first place that we go to get that assistance.
8 years ago, a first-year associate started working with a 19-year-old girl who had been raped by two neighborhood boys. Unfortunately, what she found was that the existing restraining order didn't provide for any protections for her. There was a gap in the law for sexual assault, stalking, and harassment victims who didn't have a relationship with the perpetrator. And so we decided to take that case on and really try to make a difference in changing the law.
The leadership that Mintz Levin provided around this legislation has had a tremendous impact on sexual assault survivors in Massachusetts. Prior to the legislation, we almost always had to say to them that unfortunately that protection isn't available for you.
When I was trying to access help and I had different rape crisis centers that did incredible work trying to help me and support me and stay safe, but they also, I don't think, could have worked to enact a new law without Mintz Levin and other law firms that were doing pro bono work.
I heard that law firms did pro bono work, but I thought it was taking a case here or there. I didn't realize that I could ever work with a firm and have this kind of effect on public policy.
The most important benefit of this new law is that people can get a criminally enforceable restraining order right now, today, whereas in my case, and I'm sure many others, that wasn't possible.
Now, when survivors come through our doors and they say, I need protection from my perpetrator, we're able to tell them we can get you a pro bono attorney, you can go into court, and you can get the protection that you deserve.
Well, I think Ms. Levin deserves all the appreciation and thanks from various different communities, both the legal community, surely the legislative community, and the victims, because this bill never would have passed without them, ever.
It's clear to attorneys from the first day that they're at Mintz Levin that pro bono is a significant activity that the firm places great value on. The attorneys get full credit. We don't have limits on the amount of time attorneys can spend for pro bono. The firm has put together an infrastructure that permits and, in fact, encourages pro bono activity.
It's been so personally gratifying to work on this project with a team of Mintz Levin attorneys. We've made a real difference in the lives of so many who need our help, and it's really sent a great message to other attorneys at the firm that they can do the same thing.